If Nebraska puts Anthony Garcia to death,
they will never do it.
Is an innocent man dying?
I believe so.
I believe so.
Yeah. Hunter Sherman. Clandestine, completely. No bank records. Nothing to indicate he was ever in Omaha. Okay. Does that match Brumback, Boutra, where he's at the wing stop, he's searching the internet from an IP address in Omaha, he's running his debit card in Omaha, he's stopping to get gas and beer in Council Bluffs? That's not a coincidence. It lends strongly to the position that the Hunter Sherman murder was not done by Garcia, which means this whole revenge theory has a whole lot less weight.
And whoever did it in 2013 with the Brumbecks did a phenomenal job inside the house in terms of a knife fight and not leaving DNA. You ask anybody, that's damn hard to do, because we're talking about a battle. It doesn't coincide. It doesn't fit with a guy driving into Omaha, using his debit card twice, and then using his phone to search for people to kill.
And without the Hunter murder, right, on Garcia, you have no revenge theory.
Exactly. Right. That's it. I mean, that's my closing in a nutshell. You know, they had no evidence, none, on Hunter. None. They had eyewitnesses.
The investigators from the Omaha Police Department say their visit to Anthony Garcia's house in Terre Haute was a treasure trove of incriminating evidence.
Except it wasn't. They found a bag full of papers that was half negative, half positive. To me, it was a non-starter.
You know, why would you destroy negative things that happened in his life?
Parents
and
coming.
Lay out the good stuff.
Because remember, I need for you to understand this very clearly. He had no idea that he was being investigated. This is a guy who was preparing to end his life because he was miserable. He was clinically depressed for decades, literally. Hated being a doctor and was done with it all. So in terms of what he put in that bag, he's assuming his parents, not the police, are coming to that house to collect whatever documents were out there.